Hello student, myself Professor Gada Keses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yevla. Student, we are learning the final year subject, that is nothing but the solar and wind energy. So from that subject, we are learning the unit number 1, that is nothing but the solar energy principles. So from unit number 1 up to the last lecture, we have seen some points, and in next point we are going to continue in the today's lecture. So the points: solar energy scenario, world energy features, solar radiation and its measurement, solar constant, and how does solar panel converts sunlight into the electricity, that we have seen up to the last lecture. Now in the today's lecture, we are going to see the next topic, that is nothing but the main components of the solar system. So here one diagram I have shown to you, in which all the components of the solar systems are shown here. So main components of solar system. So first main component, that is nothing but the solar panel. So all of you know, I have explained in the last lecture also, in the working of solar cell, the solar panel consists of PN junction diodes. Okay, so solar panel will receive the energy from the sunlight, that means photons from sunlight, and convert it into the electrical power. DC power will be generated, and that generated power will be stored in the battery. So to store that charge, we require the battery. So here second important point is nothing but the electrical battery, or that is nothing but the charge controller. So from that charge controller, the charge will send to the battery. Now after the battery will store the DC charges. That means we can use the DC charge from the battery, but our home appliances are working on the AC current, alternating current. So what we have to do, we have to convert that DC current into the AC current, alternate current. So how we can convert that DC current into the AC current? With the help of inverter, that all of you know. So inverter will convert that DC current from the battery into the AC current, and we can easily use that AC current in the home appliances. All of you understand? So that's are some main components which are involved in the solar systems. So let's see in the details what about the solar system. So first important components that I have shown to you, that is nothing but solar panel. So first point is shown here, solar panel. All of you have seen that solar panel. So different images are there for the solar panel. So solar panel, it is the heart of this solar power plants. That means solar panel is the components which will extract the energy from sunlight and convert it into the electrical energy. If it is absent or it is not working in the solar power plants, then your plant will not useful. That means that batteries, inverters, that all are not useful. All of you understand? So first component, that is a solar power plant. For the solar power plant, that solar panel is very important, which will extract the energy from sunlight, that is photon, into the electrical energy. That's why it is the heart of the solar power plant. Solar panel consists of number of solar cells. That means from the one cell, solar panel cannot be formed. So it will require the number of solar cells. We have got around 35 solar cells in one solar panel. That means near around 35 solar cells are there in this one solar panel. The energy produced by each solar cell is very small. That means each solar cell will able to produce very small amount of the energy. But combining the energy of 35 of them, that means in solar single solar panel, we have combined 35 solar cells. So though the electricity generated by the single solar cell is a smaller, but if we combine the energy of total 35 solar cells, then it is a enough energy to charge the 12 volt of the battery. All of you understand that? That means in the solar panel, number of solar cells are there, because every single solar cell is able to produce a smaller amount of energy. It is not able to produce the large amount of energy. So that is nothing but the solar panel. So all of you understand, solar panel has a PN type of the material also. Due to that, there will be the holes and electrons flow will be generated and current will be generated. So that is nothing but the solar panel. Second components from the solar system is nothing but the solar cell. So as we have discussed the above point, that is a solar panel, that solar panel has the solar cell. So solar cell, what we will do, they are able to generate the electricity. So it is the energy generating unit. Solar panel is not energy generating, it is a sunlight extracting. Okay, so solar cell is a energy generating unit made up of p-type and n-type silicon semiconductor. Okay, it is a electricity generating unit. So it is the heart of the solar power plant. Solar cell is nothing but the heart of the solar power plants. All of you understand that? So that is nothing but the solar panel, and that solar panel have the solar cells. So that is the second components. Now third main components in the solar system is the battery. That why that batteries are required? That solar panel will extract the sunlight from the photons and convert it into the electrical energy. But that energy generated by the solar panel is a DC. That means we can't directly transfer it to the household application. So first we have to store that energy, and to store that DC energy we require the battery. So that is the working of the battery in the solar system. Batteries are used to produce the power back or store the excess energy produced during the day to be supplied during the night time, because in the night time there will be no sunlights available. All of you understand that? So that's how the use of the battery in the solar system. Fourth main component is a DC to AC converter. And which unit will convert the DC to AC? That is nothing but the inverter. So solar panel produce direct current which is required to be converted into the alternating current to be supplied to homes or power grids. All of you understand that? So for supplying the homes or power grid we required AC current, but the generated current is the DC, so we have to first invert that into the AC and then we are able to use that current. So like that, there are four main components of the solar system. First one, solar panel. Solar panel has solar cell. The electricity generated will be stored in the battery, and from that battery, for using the current for home appliances or power grid, we have to invert that current. That's why inverter are required. So as shown in the figure, four main components are there for the solar panel. Solar panel, second one is nothing but the battery, third one is nothing but the inverters and solar cells. So that's are the main components of the solar system. And we also have seen how does that solar panel will convert electrical sunlight into the electrical energy or mechanical power. So today we will stop here for the today's lecture. Next point we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you, students.